So you are not selecting for anemic patients.
Yes.
So if a patient has got diabetes and CKD, will that person be included?
No, sir.
You won't include that?
No, okay.
You have used the term CKD and end-stage renal disease. Are they the same?
CKD is a chronic kidney damage, sir. So there are different stages in CKD depending upon the severity. End stage is the final stage.
So when you mention them, in your objective, some places you put CKD, some places you put
ESR.
Is that deliberate or is it, you think they are the same?
No, so there's a difference.
There's a difference. Okay. Thank you.
I am PhD scholar and myself Chiranjeev Bhattacharya, assistant professor, State University of Pharmaceutical Science. And I am doing an undergraduate of Dr. Abhishekar Datta, PCDA Board of Pharmacy, Washington. Introduction. Here, in this thing, we select a heterodimer heterodimers, which is commonly also known as jackfruit, which is widely distributed in the East India, West Bengal, and Karnataka. Heterodimer heterodimers is there. This compound is known for their antioxidant property also. And in this our study, we know in the Northeast India, only for the 30% of the people they are based on the modern medicine in the Northeast India. And 70% of the people till now they are believing on the folk medicines. In the Northeast of India, mainly the Manipur, the native practitioner of the Manipur, they claim that the Heterodimer heterophilus bark, they are highly using for the kidney damage. So on this, they are basis of their talent, the therapeutically important natural resources, among the natural resources used in the traditional and local medicine for the prevention of kidney damage. So here are some pharmacological profile of this plant, which already reported that this plant having preferring compound and it is adding to that isolated CD24 aqua solution, it is having the antibacterial activity, and this having it is used in the increase the glucose tolerance in normal subject in diabetic patients. So these are the few reported activity of this plant. Now coming to our main materials and methods. The plants of Heterodimer heterophilus elsewhere collected from the forest of Manipur, and this plant was presented by Dr. Bindeshwari Amar. He is a scientist in Department of Botany, IPHD, Institution of Biosensor Research, Department of Biotechnology, Government of India. He only selected the plant, and under this guideline, we stored this extracted for this study, the phytochemical study and the toxicity study of the species. We already done and we already published the paper. So there we have not included here. We already done the phytochemical study of the plant and the toxicological profile of the plant. So there we included the reference for you to know. So the plant is safe and we can use 100-200 tools. So we already published this paper. So here, albino rates of either sex from 180 grams to 200 grams are used for the pharmacological activities, and which is approved by the Institutional Medical Committee. Here, in case of nephroprotective activity, we are following two models. One model is paracetamol induced nephrotoxicity, and another model is gentamicin induced nephrotoxicity. In both the models, the studies we have conducted for 14 days. Each and every 14 days, we give the paracetamol and as well as the extract to the animal and gentamicin. Only the difference is that the dose of the paracetamol, it is 750 mg per kg, while the dose of the gentamicin, it is 60 mg per kg. And this study will continue for the 14 days. First we are going to the giving the extract, followed by the either paracetamol or gentamicin. So after the 14 day study, we are going to show some of the parameter, mainly we are included in the resultant discussion. In case of paracetamol induced nephrotoxicity, we are mainly going for two parameters. One is blood urea and another one is serum creatinine. Because we know in case of nephrotoxicity, both these things are enhanced or increases. As we found in this thing, in normal, the blood urea is at 8.1. Whereas in case of toxin, there is only paracetamol 750 mg per kg, the blood urea will increase after 14 days 94. Whereas our extract, the methanolic extract, the erythropoietin, the hormone synthesized from the kidney, are going to destroy totally. Once the erythropoietins are going to destroy, once the erythropoietins level are decreases, there is also destruction in the erythropoiesis process, that is the hemoglobin and the RBC level in the body. So here we can find one word to this one. The blood urea level, which is increased by the toxic control, again it is decreased by the all the extract. Among this bark mineralin extract, it will reduce the blood urea level. Then the same thing, the serum creatinine level, also decreases by the bark mineralin extract, which are normal for this bark mineralin too, and then after treatment with bark mineralin extract, it takes 1.20. Whereas the RBC count, it will be increases, the RBC count is increases by both the extract, among them the bark mineralin extract, the counts are maximum. The same thing we can reflect in the hemoglobin also, the hemoglobin level, which is decreases in the toxic control, again it will be increases by all the extract, and among this, the bark mineralin extract, it is found the maximum effect, is the increase level is 14.32. Here, one word I want to tell you, people, sir. I am not using any standard drugs. Because some of the people, they are using furosemide as a standard drugs. But for comparing this thing, but furosemide itself, sometimes it can possess the nephrotoxicity if the dose is excess. So, and some of the people, they are using acetyl cysteol as a standard drugs. But acetyl cysteol, it may be acting as paracetamol induced toxicity, but it is useless in gentamicin induced nephrotoxicity. So for this common purpose, we are not only using any standard drugs for this comparative studies. So from these studies, we can conclude that the native practitioner claim or traditional claim, that is they are using from their ancient period of time to the part of ectoplasmic heterophilus in the kidney damage or other organ damages, it is a proof, and we can scientifically prove that their idea are proof which we can further. We are in the process of isolation of the compounds, already isolated the compounds, their characterizations are going on for mainly responsible for these activities. In case of this histopathological study of this kidney or this organ, in case of gentamicin induced toxicity, in the first group, in the normal control, there is a normal glomerulus and intact parliament of capsules, and there is no changes in the proximal and distal tubules. Whereas in case of this toxic control, in the second level, here there is a glomerular degeneration for observed, obstruction in both the distal and proximal tubules are observed. Obstruction in both distal and proximal tubules are observed, and tubules are filled with fluids. Tubules are filled with fluids and other things. Whereas in case of this bark mineralin extract, it is observed that the histopathological study, there is normal glomerulus and there is no deposition of any fluids in this thing. Whereas in the bark aqueous extract, there are little degenerations are there. In the bark aqueous extract, there are little degenerations are there. It is further confirmed that the bark mineralin extract having the best activities. So these are the references already I told the first ones are. That myself will publish the phytochemical and aqueous toxicity of the leaves extract. Then the phytoconstitution. And then this is the second paper also, we did the ulcer protective on the same plan. So this is our public. Thank you, sir. So now we are going to try the isolated compound. What is the activity of the isolated compound? It is our next. From the same plan, from the mineralic extract, we isolated hydrogen levels. So now we are characterizing, already over characterization in the process. Now we want to do what is the isolated compound activity. This we want to check now. Our next step.
In the genetic interesting study, how did you give the gentamicin and the paracetamol?
Oral.
And how many used rats, mice?
Rats, sir. So six rats in each group.
Use the oral feeding.
For oral feedings. For both extract and as well as the dose, drugs.
So did you notice a variation in the level of
toxicity? The same result, the toxicity.
And what was your N number? What was the number of animals?
Six. N is equal to six. Six.
Okay. In your the your groups have got methanol extract.
Yes, sir.
So the extract has still got some methanol?
No, sir. No, no, you completely remove the methanol. Yes, sir. Because methanol is still a toxic substance, sir. If you are going, it can induce the things. Completely remove the methanol, sir.
Interesting. You need to study this further because your methanol extract seems to show difference consistently. Thank you.
Thank you. Next participant is N. Raghunandan Babu.
So today's topic for presentation is synthesis, characterization, and attributable evaluation of some novel phenazolamine derivatives. Coming to the contents of the topic is introduction, tuberculosis, phenazolines, methodology, antitubercular activity, results and discussion, conclusion, followed by references. Introduction, tuberculosis is a contagious infection caused by mycobacterium tuberculosis. It remains the leading cause of the worldwide death among the infectious disease. The WHO estimated that every year about 8 million new causes of tuberculosis occur and up to 3 million individuals die due to this disease. So, actually, the fresh result by the WHO is in the year 2014, 9.6 million people have felt ill with tuberculosis and 1.5 million people have caused death due to tuberculosis. And especially, this tuberculosis is a leading cause of death amongst people who are HIV positive. In the year 2014, 3 people were died due to tuberculosis. HIV positive people were died due to tuberculosis. So, coming to phenazolines, the interest in phenazoline chemistry indicates that it is active in various activities such as antidiabetic, anti-inflammatory, anti-tubercular, antifungal, etc. So we plan to synthesize novel heterocyclics containing phenazoline APS. Coming to the introduction of phenazolines, this is a 1,3-diazonephthalene represented by structure has also given names like phenmiazine, benzo-1,3-diazine, or 5,6-benzopyrimidine. It was first prepared by Gabriel in the year 1903. Phenazoline is a solid which is having a melting point of 48 degrees centigrade and recrystallized from ether. It is soluble in water and most of the organic solvents. It is basically nature. So here, before entering into the methodology, the objective of my study is, as in the year 2014, 9.6 million people were died due to tuberculosis and 1.5 million people have died due to tuberculosis, we have planned to synthesize novel phenazoline derivatives. That is, we have planned to synthesize two substituted novel phenazoline derivatives, thereby characterize them through the IR, NMR, and mass spectral data, then followed by screening for antitubercular activity. So coming to the methodology of my work, so here there is a different route for the synthesis of quinazoline derivatives through anthraquinolic acid, but I have gone with a different route to prepare two hydroxy derivatives of quinazoline derivatives. That is, I have taken a diketone reacts with aromatic anhydride and urea. And if you add 5 drops of concentrated HCl, it leads to formation of a basic skeleton of phenazoline derivative. This is the basic skeleton where this OH group is replaced with the Cl group by adding DOCl and reflexive fibers, which where I have added a long chain that is NN-dimethyl-1,3-propendiamine, which is fused in the place of Cl that is reflexive for 6 hours as a catalyst of triethylamine. I got these compounds. These are the final phenazoline compounds. Whatever the R19-27, these are the 9 compounds which have been established. And these have been screened for the anti-tubercular activity. So this is the characterization of synthesizing compounds. And this is the IR spectra of the compound R2. So there are basic peaks such as OH and NH at 3254 and 3128. And this is the proton NMR spectra of the R2 compound. And mass spectra of R2 where the molecular weight of the compound is at 304 and M+1 peak appears at 305. So if you do characterization rate of synthesized compounds are 10 to 18. So if you see the structure, in the first compounds, OH group fluid. This indicates the replacement of OH with the Cl group. That is, OH group is missing in the second category of compounds. Whereas, this is a proton and a mass spectrum, and the calculation date of the final compound, that is synthesized compounds, but the line compounds are prepared, and this is the IR spectra, where there are two NH. One NH of the previous basic quality and NH of the propyl side chain. So those are, that indicates that final compounds are being synthesized. This is the proton and mass spectrum of the same compound. Then biological activity, that is antitubercular activity. All the compounds synthesized in the present investigation were screened for antitubercular activity. The activity was evaluated against the strain Nitrobacterium tuberculosis H37RB strain by microclay alarmer blue assay method. Here the principles are: large number of inorganic salts in the medium provides substances essential for growth of mitobacterium. Sodium citrate will convert into citric acid serves to hold the inorganic cations in the solution. The albumin acts as a protective agent. Enriched medium, the albumin is treated to remove lipase, which release fatty acids to form the catalase. Dextra, toxic peroxide that will be present in the medium. Sublimation with glycerol or polysorbate 80 enhances the growth of the mycobacteria. So this is the composition of the growth medium, whatever I have used for the evaluation of antitubercular activity. And methodology, so here microplate alarm blue assay, this was done by taking 96 well microplate in order to minimize the background blue fluorescence. So it was performed in two fold dilutions. The H37RB was the strain used for the procedure. The plates were incubated at 37 degrees centigrade for 7 days. At the 7th day, 20 microliter of alarm blue solution was added, which was re-incubated for 37 degrees centigrade for 24 hours. A blue color in the well was interpreted as no bacterial growth. That means our drug has been completely destroyed the specific organism. The MIC was defined as lowest drug concentration, which prevented the color change from blue to pink. The results of antitubercular activity are tabulated. So this S indicates